Age-old rite of summer, a classic image of the season. Yes, jumping through a sprinkler. The joyous and exuberant activity gets the body moving, the heart pumping, and inevitably, laughter bubbling. As Rebecca's intense students of kinesiology, we're going to look at this action and dissect it to show you just how complicated this seemingly effortless summer fun activity truly is. We're going to take you through each phase of sprinkler jumping, namely, standing ready, running toward, launching over, landing, and laughing, and fill you in on which muscles are doing which in each of these phases. Okay, so let's go jump through a sprinkler.
The action that is about to be described is nothing more than static or ready standing. Action potential is yet to be determined, however, humans have a very economical anti-gravity mechanism and muscles simply supporting overall body mass are directly stimulated to react. Muscular activity in erect standing includes muscles in the foot, whose only activity is in the push-off phase or rising of the toes. Leg, posterior calf muscles are more active than the anterior, however, both play a large role in balancing. The hip and thigh, which play roles in slight activity. Swing produces bursts of ab and adductors working, and the iliopsoas is involved in constant activity, preventing hyperextension of the hip joint also. As well, the spine, where very slight activity in sacrospinalis or abdominalis occurs, the upper extremities, where low-grade activity occurs in a number of muscles, and not to forget the serratus anterior and trapezius that support the shoulder girdle and the supraspinatus that resists downward dislocation of the humerus.
We'll do it a couple times.
We'll have outtakes.
We'll totally do it a couple times. Just go for it.
Bring your beer.
Now we have Peg swiftly, deftly running forward toward the sprinkler. What myriad of muscles are engaged now? Let's take a closer look.
Starting with the foot on the ground, the hip flexors, the iliacus, the psoas major and minor, rectus femoris, and sartorius, along with the hamstring muscles, contract to propel the leg forward. The abdominal muscles, the internal and external obliques, and the rectus abdominis contract to stabilize the core of the body. The hip extenders, the gluteus maximus, bicep femoris, semitendinosus, semitendinosus, along with the adductor magnus, they contract to swing the leg posteriorly. The quadriceps, the rectus femoris, vastus lateralis, and vastus intermedius, vastus medialis, contract to extend the knee to prepare to bear the load of the body. The ankle begins to dorsiflex with the tibialis anterior, extensor digitorum longus, extensor hallucis longus, so that the heel is the first part of the body to strike the ground. When the heel strikes the ground, the ankle plantar flexes with the gastrocnemius, the soleus, tibialis posterior, and the peroneus longus to propel the body forward.
Next, James is jumping through the sprinkler with panache and elan. Not doing that again.
James is now launching through the sprinkler. In order to accomplish this, he will first move into a slight squat, engaging his hip flexors, namely the iliopsoas, rectus femoris, sartorius, pectineus, gracilis, and the adductor brevis and longus. The knee flexors will also engage, including the gracilis, sartorius, popliteus, the hamstring muscles, and the gastrocnemius muscles. As part of the squatting motion, James will move onto the balls of his feet and in doing so engage the dorsiflexors and metatarsal phalangeal flexors, flexor digitorum longus, flexor hallucis, peroneus longus, peroneus brevis, extensor hallucis longus, and tibialis anterior muscles. At the same time he is moving onto the balls of his feet, his arms swing back in a counter motion using the lower fibers of the pectoralis major, subscapularis, latissimus dorsi, teres major, infraspinatus, and teres minor muscles. To complete the launch forward from the squat, James will now push up and off the balls of his feet using the plantar flexors and metatarsophalangeal flexors, soleus, gastrocnemius, tibialis posterior, flexor digitorum longus, flexor hallucis, peroneus longus, and peroneus brevis. His arms will now swing forward to help propel his motion, engaging arm flexors of the pectoralis major upper fibers and the deltoid anterior fibers. At the same time, his arms come forward, so too will his knees extend to complete the launch using the rectus femoris, fastus intermedius, lateralis, and medialis, and the quadricep muscles.
Is it a leaping elegant year? No, it is but Sam now coming in for a landing on the other side of the sprinkler. She touches down with a grace that is matched only by myself. But again, what is important to us here, as Rebecca's intense students of kinesiology? Yes, you've got it. What muscles are enabling Sam to land on the other side of the sprinkler? Let's take a closer look.
Alas, we have made it through the sprinkler, but the fun's not over yet. For a brief moment, while suspending in midair, our minds may have drifted to another world and are emerging through the other side of the looking glass. But before we can think about going through again, we must first land safely. Extending the right knee using vastus intermedialis, vastus lateralis, and vastus medialis. Extending the toes with extensor digitorum longus and extensor hallucis longus, plus peroneus and tibialis anterior to flex the dorsal side of the foot to touch down. Extending the hip with semimembranosus, biceps femoris, and gluteus maximus before bringing the left leg forward in the same fashion.
Wait! I hear hysterical laughter! Yes! It is none other than our very own Allison, who has just successfully landed on the other side of the sprinkler. Have you ever wondered what muscles are engaged in this activity? Well, we have. Let's take a closer look.
And now we bring you to the ultimate and ostensibly the most frequent action that occurs during the sprinkler run sequence. It is that noble, life-sustaining cure-all, the best medicine, and the sound from children that brings joy. Of course, it is laughter. Bear in mind that when one lets loose with a true belly, or abdomen if you prefer, induced guffaw, virtually all muscles within the body structure are activated. And as we all know, that is a truly large number of muscles. In recognition of you, the viewer's potentially waning attention and interest, we will highlight 19 of the more primary movers and shakers involved with the necessary and delightful attending laughter. We have many that are involved in your head, face, and neck. We have the zygomaticus, which is your cheeks. They move your mouth upward. Frontalis, your forehead, raises eyebrows and wrinkles the forehead. Orbicularis oculi, which is around your eyes and makes you squint and blink. Rhizoris, corners of the mouth that draws your lips up like a grin. You've got the buccinator, corner of the mouth, and cheeks, and it compresses your cheeks. You have the platysma, which is in the front of your neck, and it draws the lower lip down and depresses the mandible. The masseter, which is on the side of the face, it elevates the mandible. Oris orbicularis, which is around the mouth, draws your mouth together. Temporalis, which is on the side of your head, elevates and retracts the mandible and assists in the movement of the mandible. Mentalis, which is in your lower lip, and it elevates and protrudes that lower lip. We have the depressor angularis,
It's in the front corners of your chin, and it draws the angle of the mouth and opens the mouth. Sternocleidomastoid. It's a medial anterior of the neck, and it laterally flexes your neck, and it also rotates your head side to side. Scalenes, also on the side of your neck, forward flexion stabilization of your upper rib cage, especially during inspiration. The splenus capitis, which is lateral and posterior of your neck, it extends, flexes, and rotates your head. Rectus abdominis, anterior medial abdomen, flexes the spine. External obliques, which are part of the abdomen on the anterior lateral side, compresses your abdomen and rotates your vertebral column. Internal obliques compresses the abdomen. External intercostals draw ribs superiorly to assist with inhalation, and then the diaphragm, which is in the center of the thoracic cavity, helps increase the volume of the thoracic cavity and your lungs. And these are just a small portion of the muscles that are engaged when you laugh.
So there we have it. We, Rebecca Stevens of Kinesiology, have accomplished what we have set out to do. Clearly, it is amazing that our human body can do all that it is asked to do. It is our sincere hope that you have all learned a little something, and the next time you go to engage in sprinkler jumping, give a little nod to this informational video. Thank you, enjoy your summer, and good day.
How do you feel about that?